All right, guys, this is what I got so far. Let's just keep going. Things that I see, I'd really like to venture out into really nail down the lanterns right now, and then I'll tackle everything else, and these are the finishing touches. So I want to go in, make a black, blue, and brown. Hit my shadow side of everything. Still using the same black, might be using less. Everything's getting smaller, so you can hint at less. Like, I'm not really drawing each individual roundness, each individual thing going on with the lamp. And notice I really hadn't really tackled the insides of it, and I'll talk about that in a sec maybe. I'm just hitting where I know the darks are. Remember I said that they'd flatten out as they go. I want to still hold true to that. I could come back. What my eye sees right now is like some a little bit darker values or a little bit of changes within the columns and the plaster work that I haven't done yet. And so where I see it mainly, I'll hit it. If I don't really, like, truly see it, like, it's not important. Sometimes when you're painting and you're kind of focused on one thing, and it's so easy to do, and I'm doing it right now, is to just change focus and where you, it might be more productive if you keep harping on what you're harping on. But for some reason, I wanted to just harp on this middle section a little bit more. It just made me know there's like this light section. Even a light there. And not to say that I can't come back and hit it with the blues that I kind of outlined everything with, but to make that transition not so stark. But you hit or miss those, so it's not really a big deal. And get like an orange yellow, more of a yellow start out with. Hit that middle. This is what makes things glow right here. The light in the middle wants to make everything like this dark shape that you see here, makes it want to thin out, it looks like in the video, but what it really wants to do is get warmer, and it wants to be like the surrounding light. If you can actually make it look like the surrounding light and feel as dark, you're gonna like, now I can go back in with red, fill in the red. And I can go back with the dark, come in with the dark that goes up. So all of a sudden you have this variety of like the lamp minus these dark shapes. If you take those out and just have the lamp, think about that. And then think about just that one specific line, and it's really warm in the middle. That light really warms it up. It surrounds it. It's like it covers it on the outside of everything. Like the light, this line on the very far end is not actually dark. It's like a hybrid of red and dark, but it's not dark. It's what it does is it gives you an escape route to fall back into space. But the line before it is darker, so make sure you do that. And then you can also even bypass like the warmth by just hitting or missing some of the areas. Like just hit the bottom and hit the top a little bit and your eye will connect both of them. feel like we're pretty good on that. Only thing I'd love to do would be to come back and touch these like shadow areas up, maybe. This car has some really extreme highlights on it. Let's see what that feels like with the painting instead of just the photograph. So just go back to maybe the sky color. Doesn't have to be quite as extreme. One of the things that I would love to do, and I'm gonna do it, and put a little more white out. I want to mix some more of this color for the wall. For me, I want to. I'm just gonna try to make it thicker a little bit. Maybe hit or miss. I can touch the edges up, need be. But I want to do it smart. So I'm not just going to do the whole thing at first. So I'm going to do like maybe along the path to my point, my vanishing point. Not every line has to be the same. This whole background doesn't have to be the same. I can blur. I have my brush tips dirty, but I have pink on everything else. Like if I were to do this, look at how much paint. That's just knowing what's on the tip of your brush. And how you can manipulate what's on your brush. And that just comes by feel, and that comes by time and effort and putting in hours of what's going on. Even though I just messed up a bunch of the stuff I did earlier, it's no problem. Come in, get some sort of value that is equivalent, some sort of purple that I had mixed, cut it off. I will say some of the things that you might would do carelessly, like I just did, sorta. actually push your painting forward. And so don't think, because I just like ruined my strategic vanishing point and my lines to my vanishing point that are so detrimental. Don't think that just because like I just did that, like that detours my mood. I want you to think that it's just something else, like for it to be a little bit better, because I feel like that did kind of make it a little bit better. And I do want to kind of hint at some things again, but and just because you have this like weird line right here, I'm not a fan of that line. And I can tell when I do it, and I knew that it was going to be that way, but like you touch it up on the inside, and then you touch it up on the outside. And basically, if you look at my palette now, I've gone away from piles, and it's just brush mixing, and it's definitely not conducive to painting fast or are efficient. And one of the things about painting for me, like the process that I love and the energy, is more of efficiency. Not to say that I will cut corners or anything like that. It's just, it's always been about freshness and so I feel like that's good. One thing that I'm not jiving with at this moment, and it's probably my drawing. It's definitely my drawing, but I have, and maybe I can thin it out a little bit, but the second palm right here, like if I can kind of come in and cut, make it a little bit thinner, like all of a sudden it just stops right here. Y'all see that? Where it shouldn't. And that's just because of my drawing earlier and things that I've done. So if anything, I want to cover up a line that makes this branch feel solid. If you have a palm tree, like it's always going to be a little more, it's always going to be solid straight in the center. You don't want one of the air holes in the middle of the palm tree. It's ridiculous. Because it's the most dense straight up, and then it branches out. After it ends up here, you'll have a few spikes, but you won't have everything else. So like say it ends here for me. And that's how I want to treat it right now. I'm not going to have that quite as dark. Maybe I will though. And then I'll come back with some light. I don't know. Let's do it. It's the easiest solution. Passive easiest resistance. It's not always the best path to choose, but you can come back with 3 highlights now and then I'll be done. So hopefully we'll be done in 2 or 3 minutes. So maybe white to like pop in a little more of these air holes that should be there. Maybe 1 or 2 on the other side. Just so it doesn't look so blocky. You don't want the air holes to be the same length. Like, you just don't want dots. Like, if it is a dot, at least let it, maybe one of them be blurred or even have, you know, like a, that dark blue around it or something. Just blurring that edge a little bit, make it fall back a little more. I can even come back with that same color and beef it up until it blurs out. A lot of times you can, if you have enough white out, you can just dip your brush into the fat part of it and you'll see like, it'll usually have that little tag on it, like a beak of a bird. You can come in, place that beak where you want it. Lightly touch it, it'll thicken that highlight like no other. You see there's a beak on that, and like you can take that beak and hit the areas that you want it to hit. I'm looking at this painting as a whole, like this area is now like jumping out at me. And one of the things, like I can use that thickness of paint and then now it looks like impasto, like I just puttied it. I don't like that. Like I like it to be sort of smooth, but just thicker. Not like smooth. So like I can wipe off my brush that I just used and I can lightly like maneuver that paint. Sometimes it's like delicate surgery. I don't want us to paint the way that we just feel like it should be delicate the whole time. That should not. The only time that you do delicate is when sometimes you mess up in trying to cover your tracks. But even most of the time, it's better to open up that wound and get at it and attack it like you attacked the painting before, because, or everything else before, because if you are delicate, most of the times, like, it shows. And I feel like it makes your painting weaker, or it makes my paintings weaker, as opposed to attacking them and being just being forthright and just going for it. So I'll just mix, kind of get some of that green back. And I can kind of come in here. Once you drag it through once or twice, like, you need to wipe it away and kind of go for it again. Now, I went back in, it ended up in some of the other darkness. It doesn't need to do that. I mean, how do I feel about this? I feel pretty good right now. I'm not jonesing for anything that I really hadn't thought about. And sometimes when you want to make a change and you really hadn't even. Sometimes an easy way to trim a tree trunk is to just come back in with the colors around it. Like, I can trim it easier with coming in with a darker color. Although I didn't do it as quick and professionally as I'd like. Alright, so the last thing I want to do is just touch up the dark that I just did. And that's it. And all we have left to do, ladies and gentlemen, is to sign it, frame it, and sell it. So you sharpen the edge of a brush. It's easier to sign in the dark. Usually the dark will show up better than the light. So maybe I should sign over here. Although it's really busy over here. And then maybe I could sign here. But then it'd make this area a little bit busier. So sort of like a lesson to where to sign, right? So maybe I'll just sign over here. And even, like, say right now, like, I can see this going on. Like, you can't see my name that well. Not that, I could just go like this, a dark streak, and that's fine. Inside my name in there. and you won't notice it quite as much as you would ever here in this area. If I did have any suggestions, like if I were to make anything right now, like, and keep playing with it, I might would play with some of the white light that kind of surrounds the ornamental stuff. Now that everything's kind of been played out, might help the transitioning downward. And anywhere else, maybe, I don't know. I don't really want that thick though, right there. So maybe and then all of a sudden, you see my thought process. Well, maybe I didn't like that, so maybe I'll just clean my brush and make it into something that's reasonable for me. Like a in between. And that's fine. And that, my friend, is a painting of Charleston. Remember to sign too, like, depends on what type of frame you're going to use, but at least give yourself a quarter inch of signing space on either side before you sign. In case you don't use a floating frame, if you use a lip frame, most frames are lipped. And then there you go. Happy painting.